Hello all, this is Riku Oscar Hotel 1 Echo. We are going today to install OpenGD 7.7 on the TYTMD 9600 radio. And what we need to do, we need to do a lot of stuff. We need backup the ROM file and install the firmware. So first of all, I'm using a Windows 10 computer what is 64-bit, and it's never has been installed GD77 software. So starting point of this is zero, so you need to install all the drivers and all the things what you need there. So we'll start about installing the MD9600 USB drivers, because it will not work if you are not installing the Windows drivers into it. So when you connect to radio, you will get the radio USB driver, a digital radio in USB mode. You need to go Windows update. I'm very sorry, this is Finnish language, Windows 10, but you know where you have a Windows update, and from where you need to get the optional drivers, and there you need to click to install the driver. So from there you just wait to install the STM Electronics DFU mode driver, and after that the USB driver will work. Not much people has knowledge about this, because if you do this normally and you restart computer and you other things, it will do automatically, but this will only fast your things up, and after that it will work. So let me fast forward the video. After the driver install, you will get on the device manager the STM device in the DFU mode. So after that you will have a working factory driver on the radio. After that you will need to install the MD9600 them from the radioditu.com website. So you will go there and download the software, and after that you will install in your PC. So there is a you need to go that site and select car radio, and after that you need to download the right software for it. So it's only a CPS what you are needing from this one. You are not needing the software, the firmware. The firmware you are downloading from the other site later. So you need to watch out what you are doing. So this CPS, you are doing this because you are downloading the calibration data from the radio. You need to do that, or your radio will... You cannot turn it back after this if you are not doing this. So you just download it and install on your Chrome computer. After that, when you have installed it, you are going to open and download the thing. You will open the CPS and after that you will read from radio to see that's working how it's supposed to work. So the USB is working fine. You will see the version 2.08 on my radio. After that, you are going to open GD77 forums and read the instructions. And you there found the instructions from installation. And you need to follow those. I'm doing this only from those. You really need to follow those or you are busted. So after that, you are need to control and T on the CPS. So we are going to do that now. You will see calibration data and you will download that from the radio and save that to a safe location. Just remember to save that on safe location, so you will click save test data and save that on your hard drive and after that make 100 different backups on the different clouds and everywhere. And this is only the first backup what you are need to do. You will need to do a couple more later. So after this you are ready to install the firmware. So to do that you need to get the CPS and the firmware files from the OpenGD77.com.
You will go to the firmware download link
and there you will click on readme. There is more instructions and there you will find another firmware. So you will need to download that one. It's version 5 radio. So you need to download those because the codec it's extracted from that file. So you'll download that and extract the file on your PC on this place where you know. So on my case I extracting that to the firmware version 5. You do this in your own way, so just do it a place where you know where you are going to put that. After you have done that, you will need to download the firmware uploader loader and that application you will just extract again. In your way, do it this how do you do in your PC. I'm just doing this way. Extract there and open the loader. When you have the loader open, you will need to choose both firmwares there. To get radio firmware, you need to go again to the OpenGD77 forums and select there the firmware. Alpha version available for download. Last post on when at this time what I was doing, you need to look it for it. It's a last post at this moment. So you will need to get that. And I did download both, but I use it version 2, I guess. Or version 4, but anyways, download the firmware. After you have been downloaded the firmware, you need to open firmware downloader and select the files. First, you will get the downloaded file from the version 5 firmware, the bin file, where you will extract the codec. And now you'll have DMR functionality. After that, you need to select the other file, what your radio is, the version 4, version 2. That file, what you downloaded. So, on my case, it will be the version 2. And after that, you need to connect radio. Disconnect the power, press the orange FP1 button and press the power on from the wire, not the radio. And then you will press the upload and it will upload the firmware on the radio. When the update is finished, you will get OpenGD77 screen. And after that, you have a fully functioning OpenGD77 radio. So now, the next step is taking again the backups. You will have 1666 first time on the screen. You will download OpenGD77 CPS and install it on your PC. Just do it like normally do. And after that you will install the driver, a USB driver of radio. You will select MD9600 and you will first download the flash data. This is the most important part, because without this you cannot return to the factory default. So you will just backup flash first, and it will take some time, so be patient for it. Go do coffee or something like that. And after you have downloaded the flash data, you will backup as well to MCU ROM from the radio. And just save it on the good location. And backup the MCU too and save that as well. I did read from radio. I downloaded a code plug, my own code plug from my page, just to get something there. And after that, I read from radio to see the USB is working. And after that, I opened my code plug and overwrote that original one. And after that, the radio was working fine. You need to check the buttons from the instructions. So the buttons will be a bit odd, but it will work.
Oho, ykkönen ei kokeile. Oho, ykkönen ei kokeile. Oho, yksi ei kokeile. Oho. yksi kokeile. Radiokokeilu.
And okay, you are volunteer firefighter. Okay, good. Actually, last week we had a huge wildfire here in. We have had rain for 3 months, but it was very dry. And a small spark. And the last 9 days, because of heavy wind, more than 1,000 firefighters participated, but couldn't control wildfire at all. And more than 50, I heard it's exactly 47 helicopter participated, but couldn't control at all. So it is the last 9 days, and finally we had rain the day before yesterday. And then it will continue here.